Good morning, Lincoln. I'm Camila.
And I'm Savannah.
And welcome back to The Morning Roar. So, this is our second episode with Savannah.
Woo!
Really exciting. I love that we're back on air. And speaking of going back to things, we're back to another Would You Rather with our amazing team of Paige, Sydney, and Emily. So, we'll look at that.
Yeah.
And then we'll give our opinions.
Because we know you guys want to hear those. Reminder that after we give our opinion, of course, we want to hear your guys' opinion. So feel free to leave a comment about what you would rather do. And if you guys have any ideas for like a new Would You Rather video, leave that in the comments too.
True. Let's get on with it.
I'd rather sing karaoke with Olivia Rodrigo.
I'd rather sing in karaoke with Olivia Rodrigo.
I would rather sing karaoke with Justin Bieber!
I'd rather marry the most attractive girl in the world.
I would rather marry the best cooker.
I'd rather marry the most attractive person I've seen.
Yeah, me too.
I'd rather someone see all those photos in my phone.
I would rather someone see all my photos in my phone.
I would rather someone see all the photos on my phone.
Mostly landscape and pictures of my cousins and my brothers.
Yeah, like, I mean, you might find some dumb memes in my photos, but like, I don't know. It's kind of weird to like read your text. But also, with would you rather be with the best cook or the most attractive person? Okay, I'll be honest with you. I'd rather be with the most attractive person because they would be really cute and beautiful. Yeah. They do to me. No, I'm joking. That sounds evil. No, it's just that, I mean, I love food and I also can't cook. So, like, the best would be, like, an intermediate between
yeah.
the two. But I'll be honest with you. Like if I'm not attracted to you, that's kind of a deal breaker. But, like,
that's fair.
If you suck at cooking, I don't really care. I'm not going to be like, ew.
I guess we're just okay, ordering takeout every night.
Yeah. Well, okay, to be fair, I wouldn't be ew either way because that's kind of evil. But that's not the point. Next up, we have a Rise Up little, like, safety PSA, a little goofy one by some of our younger journalists.
It's actually really fun. I watched them film another video today, and they are definitely an energetic group of people.
Woo. Well, I can't wait to see this video. Let's take a peek.
Oh no! Oh my goodness! Gosh, golly!
Should we help him?
Nah.
No, come on, we gotta help him.
Why don't?
Are you okay, Poppy?
Yes! Just remember, safety is key, and next time, keep your head up, or else accidents like this will happen again.
Alright, thank you guys.
I am Luke Cavanaugh, and be safe.
Wow, that was a pretty unique video.
Yeah, it was interesting.
It was really funny, but like, how do y'all think of these? Like, some of these, it reminds me of like our older stuff, like from like
yeah.
10 years ago. Like, they were hilarious, but it's like, honestly, like, I would try to be like, huh, I want to make a funny video, and I just like, that, it was very creative. I thought it was really funny.
I don't think that would have ever come to me to do that type of video.
Yeah, but thank you guys for making it.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. And, you know, next up we have my fit check, you know, coming back. It wasn't on last week, which is so sad. I'm sure you guys missed that so much.
Mm-hmm.
The 1 week we didn't have it. So sad. But it's back this week. So I hope you guys like it. I hope you like it, Savannah.
Of course. I got to watch you film it the other day.
Shh. Anyways, let's look. Hi guys, it's Camila and welcome back to Fit Check. So I have this sort of like celestial outfit kind of planned out. So here I have, so what I did is I layered this. I'm pretty sure it's either supposed to be a top for like a crop top for like a tween, or it's supposed to be like a trainer bra. I'm not exactly sure, but it's like this cute like velvet pattern, and I thought it'd be such a waste to wear that under clothes. So I layered it over this long black shirt. I got this black shirt at Marshall's. And then I want to go for more avant-garde silhouette, so I added this longish skirt. Well, long skirt. Only kidding, it's pretty long. And then added these blue velvet ankle boots. And then for jewelry, I have this star and moon necklace that I thought would go cute with the theme, and then just my earrings. So, I hope you liked my little video, my little, you know, I don't know what else to call it. Did you like my outfit?
It was quite cute.
Aw, thank you. Because when I went home, my sister was like, what are you wearing? And she just doesn't get it for real. That's, like, she just doesn't get it for real. Anyways, next up, we have a video about the press box, because it's finally back, you know, after that devastating...
Oh, goodness. What was the storm?
It, was it a tornado? It was a tornado.
Was it a tornado?
I'm pretty sure it was like a mini tornado.
Yeah. That took our press box and went...
Yeah, at the perfect time. I still remember the student section without... Honestly, the student section was more hype with the press box there.
Yeah.
I feel like people felt more inclined to be like, yay, when they're all like right next to each other. Yeah. But I honestly preferred it without the press box.
Just a little bit?
Because it was kind of like airy. It was kind of nice. No. Also, I don't know. But I do like the press box, and I'm glad that it's back, so I am excited to see this video about it, because I want to know what the story was, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Let's take a look-see.
It's been a long year, especially the fall season, without the press box. But now, ready for the spring sports, the press box is back in action, looking better than ever.
For this year's football season, the vibes were off due to us not being able to have the bleachers and also the press box. Obviously, we lost the press box due to the tornado, but hopefully next year we can show more school pride and be more energetic due to getting these bleachers back.
The press box definitely establishes school pride and helps us express it in a more vibrant way, especially during this fall season. And now that we get to do in the spring season, I think everyone's ready to get back in action outside, outdoors, on Ferguson Field, ready to cheer on the Lincoln Lions. Word on the screen, you read what you sow. Not out of fear,
but love. Love for the game. Rock family. Honestly, like, is it just me, or does it, like, did the press box, like, look, like, even, like, prettier? Like,
it did.
I was like, man, are they just living in, like, color land or something?
I know.
Because it looked, like, nicer.
I've never been in it, so I don't really know what to compare to the past, but I'm like, our field doesn't look that nice until I'm looking at it from the press box, dude. I'm like, oh, the field looks really nice.
Yeah, it was actually like, I don't know. I thought it looked really pretty, and I'm glad that it's back. I do agree. Like, the vibes were definitely different this year, and I think that it's, like, important to, like, the spirit of the games. So I'm glad that it's back.
Especially because Lincoln is a very big sports school.
Yeah.
Well, so to have something like that missing when you're announcing football games and stuff like that definitely dims the school vibe.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. And next up, do you wanna take this one, Savannah? The Turn Up Thursday?
What's your favorite song right now?
My favorite song right now is Carnival by Kanye West. Every day I dress all black,
for show not honey brags. My favorite song right now is Teenage Fever by Drake.
Funny that it's always been all about you from the start.
What's your favorite song right now?
Favorite song has to be Dreams and Nightmares by Meek Mill.
I used to pray for times like this, to rhyme like this, so I had to grind like that.
My favorite song right now is 16 by Baby Keem. I don't know, I just like the beat, and I just like the lyrics.
Born in the streets, tell nobody that you never had it. Don't tell nobody.
What's your favorite song right now?
Probably gotta say Carnival.
Yep, Carnival.
Why?
It really just, like, opens up my ears and allows me to feel the music, you know?
Yes. Me too.
Okay. What's your favorite song?
Humble by Lil Baby.
Now dance.
What did he say?
Decided to speed it up, you ain't driving Miss Daisy. Rolls Royce truck plus, yeah, you driving Lil Baby.
What's your favorite song?
Stop Breathing by Playboi Carti, because the beat and the way he, like, raps on it.
My favorite song, my name's Eli, by the way, that's Kev. My favorite song is probably
90210 by Travis Scott. He opens up and stuff, so.
Dance.
Yeah.
What's your favorite song?
My favorite song is Barry Bonds by Kanye West, because, I don't know, I just like it.
Paid paper folk game it, they can't stand it, they want something new.
My favorite song is Good Days by SZA.
Edge out to some ice, but you'll be heavy in my mind.
Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside.
What's your favorite song?
I'm gonna go with Shirt by SZA. Got a good beat to it, nice little tune, you know.
Getting dug right now, feeling lost, but I like it.
My favorite song is Switch Wing by John Barrows.
Pull up on three and I shoot it like Wayne.
What's your favorite song?
My name's Elias Gaff. My favorite song is probably Carnival by Kanye West, because he's like dating Kim Kardashian or something.
What's your favorite song?
My favorite song is Right Through Me by Nicki Minaj.
Get close.
That I update every once in a while for my own self, okay? Top song is Kidnapping an Heiress by Black Box Recorder. Georgia knows what I'm talking about. Second one is, this is a stupid name, but Sexy by Metric. Third one is Rent by Pet Shop Boys. Fourth one is Come Undone by Duran Duran, okay? And I feel like right now my fifth one is like Digital Bath by Deftones. So I need to update my playlist because it's not exactly in the right order. But that's what I would say. What about you?
I was just gonna say one song. I really enjoyed the song Set Fire to the Rain. That's kind of a slower song, and I know that. I know it's not really mixed by
Adele?
Rock. Yeah.
Oh my god, I remember I would sing that when I was like seven. Bro, I would be like,
oh,
I set fire. Bro, these go hard. Not saying that's like a childish song. It's Adele. That'd be kind of evil. Adele isn't, she's not exactly childish. She's very soulful. I wish I could sing as well as her. I remember when my parents watched the first music video like they ever saw by her, they were like, man, she could sing. And I was like, yeah, I wish I could sing. It would be nice. I can't sing at all. Oh, well. Yeah. Is that all?
One other update. Remember that there is the book drive going on currently. It's through April 22nd. So if anybody's interested, they're looking for new or used books, as long as the used books are in decent condition. No ripped pages, no broken spines. I mean, I get it. I doggy ear my page. So my books, don't judge me for that one. I hate bookmarks. I lose them. So like books like that are fine, but if it's ripped or the spine is like broken, they ask you just don't donate them. Other than that, I think that's all we've got.
Yay! Aw, thank you so much for coming back this week, and we're so happy to have you guys. Thank you guys for watching, and bye!
Bye.